Hello everyone. In the previous video, we learned how to create a website using ERP Next. In this video, we will learn how we can customize our homepage, which is already present in the system, and we will also learn how to create a new homepage and set it to this particular route. Okay, so now the homepage is set to this route, that is home, which is the already existing homepage in the ERP Next system. So let's go to homepage. Alright, so this is what we can see it over here. This is Build Awesome Things Data Driven Analytics. So this is particular, that is the homepage which is set to. Now we have this hero section which is based on three different things. That is default, it can either be slideshow, it can either be homepage section. Now what is a hero section? Hero section is this particular section that we see this much where my cursor is pointing. Alright, so we can add a tagline, we can also mention the description about the company, and we can add the background image. Now right now, currently this particular module is under development, so that's why the background image is not loading. Alright, so the next is I can also add a URL for products if your website is an e-commerce website, and if you add a product, then that will show on the home page over here. Okay, now let's go and change the hero section to slideshow. Now what will happen is instead of this Build Awesome Things, here it will show a slideshow. Okay, let's just save it and we can see it. So this is the particular slideshow that I've already created. You can also create your own slideshow from, let's go. So this is how you create a slideshow. You can add different images, you can also enter the headings in the description. And one more thing, okay, now the next section is we can change it to the homepage section if I save it. So this is the homepage section that I have added. Okay, now let's go to the homepage section. This is the homepage section named MyPad. So here I have let this section be based on a cards, which means I have a different cards over here. That is, one is a job card and then we have a product card. So likewise, you can add different cards depending on what your website is or what is the functionality of the website, which means what your website represents. So right now I have added a jobs in the products, and I've also added the routes over here. That means if I click on more details, I'll get to see this particular more details about it, and then if I go on the products, then if I have the items present in my website, then those items will be present over here. Okay, so this was about the section in the home page. Now I'll just set this hero section based on default because it's looking more good compared to other different sections that I have. Alright, so this was about the already present web page which was set to home in the system. Now suppose if I don't want this particular page, okay, I want to create my own new page and I want my own slideshow in it. So we can also do that. So let's just go to the web page list. Okay, now this is the home page which I've already created. Let's get into it. Now this is a title and we have a route. I have set it to the new home. So if I change this route in the website setting, so this whole page will change, which we will do in some time. Okay. Now if I set it to full width, that means the website will be shown in the full width. All right, now we have the content type over here. So these are the different content types. Depending on your preference, you can choose any. We can also choose HTML and make a website. Now right now I have kept it as a rich text. That means I will only mention the text inside of it, and that will be shown on the web page. Okay, you can also add a JavaScript, any script that you want, and then you can also add a style. So let's say I want the background color. So right now the background color is white. Okay, if I want the background color to be set to, let's say, very light gray, then I'll use this particular settings over here. And the next is let me just save it and we will see that in the website settings. All right, I'll just set this route to new home. Alright, so here you can see that I have a slideshow over here which I have added, and then I also have this rich text which I was just talking about. And here we have a sidebar. The sidebar is showing because we have enabled it in the web page. So here we have enabled our sidebar, that's why it's showing this particular sidebar. Okay, now if you want, you can also create your own sidebar and you can add different pages that you want to. Suppose if you want to add a link to your previous blog post, or if you want to add a link to, let's say, a contact page, so you can also add that. Now right now I'll go into this, and this is what I have added. I've added just simply a book appointment section over here as a sidebar. I'll go to the book appointment, and here from here I can book the appointment. Okay, now let's go back and see some more different sections that we have. All right, now this is the header section. Okay, now I can add the color, different color in there. So, and I can also add some meta tags in this particular home page. Now these are like not so much importance, not of that much importance. So we'll just go through all this, and I hope you understood it. Okay, so these are the settings that we can see. Let's just save it, and okay, I'll do it full width and we'll see the changes, how it looks. Okay, so yeah, this was about it. It's full width. And what happens if I remove the sidebar? Let's see. Yeah, so the website has now changed into the full width, like it's taking the whole width of my laptop, and this is it. But I think the full width is not looking that much good, so let's just enable our sidebar and uncheck this and save it. So this is about it. So I hope you understood how to create a home page and how you can also change the route, and how if you want to add a different sidebars, you can also add it. And if you want to add a different section, and if you want to, suppose if you want to edit this particular section using an HTML, so you can add your custom HTML into it. So this was about the home page. In next video, we will learn how to create a website theme and how to make it enabled on this particular page. All right, thank you so much for watching.